हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर सी आर चौगुले, हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश, गोपाल कृष्ण गोखले कॉलेज, कोल्हापूर। दिस लेक्चर इज फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ बीए फर्स्ट ऑप्शनल इंग्लिश। नेम ऑफ द पेपर सेकंड इज मॉडर्न इंडियन राइटिंग इन इंग्लिश ट्रांसलेशन फॉर द सेमिस्टर सेकंड। लेट अस नो द पोयम सो वेरी फार अवे, रिटन बाय जीएम मुक्तिबोध। गजानन मुक्तिबोध वॉज बॉर्न इन मध्य प्रदेश एंड इज रिगार्डेड एज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट प्रोमिनंट हिंदी पोएट्स, एसेस्ट, लिटररी एंड पॉलिटिकल क्रिटिक्स एंड फिक्शन राइटर्स ऑफ द 20th सेंचुरी। ही ऑल्सो रिमेन्ड असिस्टेंट एडिटर ऑफ जर्नल्स लाइक नया खून एंड वसुधा। ही इज वाइडली कंसिडर्ड वन ऑफ द पायोनियर ऑफ मॉडर्न पोएट्री इन इंडिया। एक्सपेरिमेंटलिज्म मूवमेंट ऑफ हिंदी लिटरेचर एंड इट वॉज ऑल्सो हिज वर्क फॉर मार्क्ड culmination of this literary movement and its evolution into the Nayi Kahani and Nayi Kavita in 1950s. His presence is equally important in the rise of new criticism in Indian literature. Muktibodh started out as an important poet, being published in the first three volumes of Tar Saptak series of anthologies, which marked a transition into Hindi literature from the prevalent Chhayavad movement. This led to the initiation of प्रगतिवाद प्रयोगवाद इन हिंदी पोएट्री, इवेंचुअली लेड टू द क्रिएशन ऑफ द नई कहानी न्यू स्टोरी मूवमेंट दैट इज मॉडर्निज्म। मुक्तिबोध रिजेक्टेड मॉडर्निज्म एज ही थॉट दैट द रिच विथ देयर पॉवर ऑफ मनी एंड पॉलिटिकल अथॉरिटी हैव बीन द एक्सप्लॉयटर्स। नियरली अ फॉर्मलिस्ट अप्रोच गिविंग अनड्यू इम्पॉर्टेंस टू स्ट्रक्चर्स एंड फॉर्म्स ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन नॉट इट्स कंटेंट एंड मैसेज फॉर ह्यूमैनिटी। लेट अस नो द सेंट्रल आइडिया ऑफ द पोयम So Very Far Away. Muktibodh had embraced the Marxist ideology which advocates even bloody revolution for quick change to demolish the rule of the capitalist who exploits and establish the rule and dignity of the proletarist who work and produce wealth. They are the real people who are exploited and suffer and have no dignity. However, the people refer to in opening line of the poem, So Very Far Away, are not the proletariat, they are the middle classes, educated people. They keep themselves away from and are indifferent to and even despise the suffering and exploitation of the multitudes, the common people. They are precious for the poet. He speaks for them, loves them. Therefore, he is also disliked by the world. The epics are blood-stained because it is the blood of these common exploited people for ages together with no relief. द पोएट हेट्स सच कैलस इनडिफरेंट सेल्फ सेटिस्फाइड पीपल. दे आर हैप्पी टू लिव विद द स्पिरलिंग स्टेयरकेस ऑफ करप्शन एंड कैश. They have made the whole world unclean and it needs thorough sweeping by an able scavenger which the poet is not. The work is serious and needs to be done immediately. The corruption, exploitation and indifference is starving the daughters of the poor, the deprived. The exploiters, the capitalists are those who make and own high-end cars like Chevrolet and Dodge. The exploited are those underground rich correcting disorders under the cars, their oil-covered blackboard bent, crushed under the exploitation. By the capitalist. So Very Far Away is an angry poem of protest and expectations. The anger and protest is against the haves, the rich who won the means of production and exploitation of the proletariat, the poor. Human history is full of the stories of heartless exploitation of the poor, the disadvantaged and the downtrodden all over the world. The rich with their power of money and political authority have been the exploiters. Marx once said that all property is theft. The rich are the thieves. They have stolen the wealth produced by the poor labor and farmers, the haves not. Only a bloody revolution can bring about a quick and thorough desired change in the social structure in which there will be no class discriminations and therefore no exploitation. The means of production of wealth will be owned by the producers of wealth and not by the rich. However, the speaker feels that he is not powerful enough to bring about such a revolution. He is isolated, lonely, like the helpless, unorganized workers, laborers, etc. For them, the only truth is a sequence of grief. No change is possible if there is no awakening to the bare realities of life. Knowledge of one's deprivation is very necessary for uplift. The speaker feels diffident because this power to fight is missing, because he, as the representative of the Dalit, is isolated, lonely. The fight is unequal. People have to come together for a fight and resultant redress. Thanks for listening me carefully and attentively. Thank you.